What's going on, family? I actually tried to squeeze Black Panther in a minute. And I couldn't do it. So you have like whatever, however long it takes. 1966. The Black Panther, the character, was created. Stan Lee brought him out, and he came out actually before the Black Panthers were formed. All right, so it's no association. But this is the biggest thing, the biggest takeaway for Black Panther, the character in the comic book, was it depicted a black man that was a great fighter. He was strong. He was a leader, an engineer, a scientist. I mean, he could do just about anything. And of course, he had to learn the cultures of his land. Philanthropist. He's pretty much done everything. And it was unheard of for somebody coming out of, you know, the situation. And what I mean coming out of the situation is blacks were portrayed as being dumb and just like foolish, like whitewash, you know. And Stan Lee actually wrote Whitewash, 20 years before Black Panther. So it was definitely a great turnaround for the imagery, you know, and it kind of gave people hope. And people were looking at the comics. And then if anybody that like Storm, Black Panther and Storm actually dated during Storm's come up through Africa, and they separated, you know, they went their own ways. Storm became who she was, but then they later got married. You have to look at the story. It was one of those situations where fans didn't like how they broke the marriage up. It was crazy. But one thing about Black Panther in the comic book, it reflected like real world stuff and stuff that we go through on a regular basis. And it just gave people hope. Honestly, you know, it's like, hey, it's bad enough that blacks were being depicted as like these mindless animals in real life. And then we get into the comic or fantasy realm, and like we're still like below the equal barrier and or equality barrier. And now Stan Lee did right by Black Panther, which brings us to Chadwick Boseman, which embodied so many different characters from James Brown, which, you know, Get On Up is on Netflix. Go check it out. Thurgood Marshall and so many other characters. And you know what that did? It was a testament to, you know, progress. That's it. It was a testament to progress. And just seeing when Chadwick died, it's like the character died. You know, it was like, hey, if you make another Black Panther, you can't make it with him. You can't make another Black Panther. And I know they got another one coming up, but it was the outpour, everything. I remember what, like, I was in my driveway when I heard about it. And though Black Panther still lives on in the Marvel Universe, it was, man. So, in a way, we're celebrating Chadwick as well as Black Panther. Chadwick, dude, was phenomenal. He was a king. He was a king for the role. He fit. He embodied that role and the whole entire Wakanda experience. That entire struggle between, you know, country and helping outsiders. Think about it. That relates to what we go through right now. So this is why I say, you know, this is the end of Black History Month, and it's not the end of Black History. You know, 28 days, we get it. But, you know, it's 365 days out of a year that we could be celebrating this history that, you know, kind of needles and threads itself. So we all get to contribute and get to celebrate all of this, all of the history. We get to celebrate it. But as far as the Black Panther is concerned, one of my all-time favorites outside of Wolverine and The Incredible Hulk, he is in my top five, and that's that. So thank you for listening to me. Thank you for riding with me throughout this history moment. And I hope you guys learned some stuff, man. Let me know who is your favorite character. I don't care what race they are. Who's your favorite Marvel character? Put it down below.